What's happening, folks? My name is David Curran, and I've been an educator for the last 10 years. And we all know that classroom management is key. So today, we're going to talk about classroom management in a FigJam file 101 style. We're going to go over file organization, we're going to be talking about student accountability, and we are going to be walking you through lesson flow. It's going to be lit. Let's go. As educators, we know that organizing our classrooms is highly important. So organizing digital learning experiences is also a value we have. Today, we're going to be talking about, in a FigJam, how to name a section, move a section, and hide sections, all for the purpose of classroom organization. Let's say I have this beautiful pros and cons list. Now, these are all different things. This is a table. We have text right here, and we have some other text boxes. But I want to bring those back by hitting Control Z, because I messed them up, and they're all detached. I want them to be all in one space, and I want to be able to move them around the canvas easily. So I can wrap a section around all these elements by going down to sections here. I can then left click and drag over all of these elements. You'll see them highlighted. Now, if I zoom out just a tad, wherever I move this section, all of those elements stay contained inside that section. Now I want to name this section, and I'm going to name this Pros Cons Group 1, because I have a couple groups that I'm gonna be working with today. And that's how I can go ahead and make a section and name a section. I can also move the section around, which is pretty fantastic. Now, the next thing I can do is, if I want to hide this section because I do not want students to see it quite yet, I can click on the section name right here, click on this eyeball icon, and I can hide it. Hiding sections can be incredibly useful when you have multiple things on a FigJam file that you want students to do, but don't want them to be overwhelmed by the amount of content on the page. So for example, if I want my students first to go to the pros and cons list, but I don't want them overwhelmed or distracted by this beautiful timeline down here, I click on timeline, hide the timeline, and what students see when they log into this is they'll just see the pros and cons list. It'll help direct their attention and focus to this section, and we'll get them working right away where they need to be. We know that student accountability is a must if we're gonna have successful lessons in our classroom. So today we're gonna be walking you through how you can lock elements, how you can add authorship, and stamps, all in the sake of having great student accountability inside of a FigJam file. Let's say that my students have filled out this pros and cons list. Now, they could move the section around like we said before, but I could lock that entirely if I don't want them to move it. But let's say that they're going inside here and they're accidentally moving elements like the pros and cons table. I can right click on this, I can go to lock, and now they cannot move it unless they click and unlock it, which you'd probably want to tell them, don't unlock things without asking. Inside here, they can still move elements around and place things onto the canvas, but they cannot directly change that element of the table. Another thing that's great for student accountability is the use of authorship. So let's say I'm looking at these wonderful answers and I want to know, wait, who wrote this one on reduced materialism? This quill icon right here, if you click on it, it will show who the author of that sticky note is. I'd always leave authorship on unless you're doing something anonymous. Right here, we can see David's doing a great job. I also had a prompt up here where I want students to add some stamps as to if they love the idea or needed some more convincing. I can go on over and I can actually see who stamped this by hovering over the stamp, clicking on it, and wow, looks like David has been really active, my goodness, on adding feedback to his peers. Student accountability, their names are attached if they're logged into FigJam through Google, and all of their work will be saved with their name attached to it, all for student accountability in FigJam. We all know that a part of classroom management is how your lessons flow. So today in FigJam, we're gonna look at how to duplicate sections to make those lessons flow nicely, how to spotlight yourself so students can follow you, and how to change a student who might be having a hard time to a view-only participant. To duplicate sections and to create great lesson flow, or maybe even different activities for different groups, you're gonna click on the section and hit Control D. If you have a number at the end of your section title, and if you keep hitting Control D, it will name that section with the corresponding number of the duplication. Here we have a activity for each one of the groups in my class. If I have ways that I color them, I can show you in a second how to do that. But first, let's go ahead and duplicate the timelines for each group. I'm gonna hit Control D, Control D, and Control D. Nice, looks really great. One important thing is to make sure that before you duplicate, if you want them to be as snappy and as nice as that, you would have them be the same width before you duplicate. Now, if I want students to be able to find this a little bit more easily, I'm gonna hold down Shift, and I'm going to recolor each one of these to correspond. If my groups have color themes, then they can find their colors a little bit more easily. And now I have some great organization. This looks great, but is a little clumped. I'm going to select all of these here. I'm going to zoom in and I can spread them out ever so slightly. Maybe I want to add some directions in for each group. And now my lesson's looking great. Some students might be a little overwhelmed by this. So let's go ahead and hide the sections of the timeline. I'm going to hold down Shift and click on each section title and then I can auto hide all of those at the same time. Now my students know where their group is, where they're supposed to go, where they're supposed to add their stickies. But let's say if a student's having a particularly hard time following where the lesson's supposed to be, I could say, hey everyone, let's go ahead and go on spotlight mode. I can then click on my icon at the top right. I can click spotlight, and then all students will be taken to the place in the canvas that I am on. I can zoom in and we can talk about a student's answer over here. I can go ahead and zoom in on what group three is doing, share some incredible, fantastic work. And let's say if there is a student who's having a particularly hard time following the lesson or being on task, I can go over into my share and I can change from edit access to view access, have a side conversation with that student on digital citizenship, and then invite them back in when they are ready to participate well. And that sums it up, folks, for classroom management inside of a FigJam 101. Just to review, we talked about file organization, how to really make sure students are being accountable for the work they're doing or not, and then how to make your lessons flow so students can follow along and get lots done. I hope you enjoyed. Please let me know in the comments below how we could make these videos better to help suit you as a teacher this year in your classrooms. Take care and have a good one.